A year and a half ago, while everybody was out celebrating the Raptors NBA championship, City News reporter Christina Howerton was in a transplant ICU celebrating her new life. After being diagnosed with end-stage kidney disease and tied 9 to 10 hours daily to a dialysis machine, Christina's brave cousin donated one of her kidneys, saving her life. Joining us this morning to chat about kidney health awareness and the third annual hashtag 6 Degrees Challenge is Christina Howerton, looking the picture of good health. Thank goodness, and God bless you and your cousin. So good to see you, Christina. How have you been? I love your blonde locks, by the way, the platinum blonde.
Thank you, Dina, and so nice to see you. It's so nice to actually speak with you. It's been a while.
You look incredible. Let's talk about that. When you were diagnosed, how far along was the progression of the disease with you?
Actually, I wasn't caught until I was end stage, so I only had between 6% and 8% kidney function. I'd been tired and run down, and I had really dry skin, but I thought, you know, it's winter time and this job could be pretty stressful. So I kind of equated a lot of things to outside factors, but yeah, when they caught it, I was end stage, and my physician's office called me and said, you have to go to ER right now. And I was in the middle of a work day. I was getting ready to go do another interview. And I had the good fortune of working with a cameraman who said, no, we're not doing this story. You're going to ER. And it was just a bombshell.
Devastating diagnosis. And then being on dialysis that long is just, it's terrifying. It's such an ordeal. Shout out to my uncle. He was on dialysis for 6 hours a day, and that was a long time, my Uncle Mario. So what was going through your mind at that time?
Really, I was very hopeful. So I was really hoping that this would come to an end soon. I was really focused on trying to look at the positives. Like, hey, it's a good thing that I got diagnosed at the very end because I didn't have to have years and months of worrying. Like, I really tried to turn all of the negatives into positives. I was thankful that I was able to do this at home so I could continue to work and continue to be a journalist and not have to worry about going to dialysis in the middle of the day at a hospital. Mm-hmm. And when my mom found out that she was not a suitable candidate, I was more concerned about how she felt than about what that meant for me. Because they told me I had about a 7-year wait on the organ transplant list based on my blood donor type or my blood type. So I knew that I wasn't going to be able to make 7 years. But I just really tried to focus on the positives.
And then there was your cousin, your angel here on Earth.
Yeah,
what a relief when you heard, right, that she was a match.
Oh, it was wonderful. I mean, I still have right behind me a picture of her and I. I don't know how to do this, but there you go. That's the one. That's us right after the transplant, and that's us in a magazine spread. But yeah, she immediately stepped up and said, "Let me do this. I'm gonna do this." And it was phenomenal. I mean, I have no idea how she was just so brave, because her surgery was actually more complicated than mine. But she's an angel and a saint, and I don't know anybody in the world that is that generous. So I am so thankful for Christine.
My gosh, what a blessing. And this affects 1 in 10 Canadians. So if people think, oh, what are the chances? It's higher than you might think, which is why there's the 6 Degrees Challenge. Tell us about it.
Yeah, it's actually 4 million Canadians, just as you said, 1 in 10, are impacted by kidney disease. And it's a disease that happens to target racialized communities. So Caribbean and African Canadians and Indigenous communities tend to have about 3 times higher rates of contracting the disease. And so it's very prevalent. So with those kind of numbers, at most, we're all 6 degrees away from kidney disease or knowing somebody with kidney disease. So the Kidney Foundation of Canada, and specifically in Ontario, is really trying to raise awareness of this. They're asking people to take a picture of themselves, use the hashtag 6 Degree Challenge, and they're trying to raise awareness, but also to raise funds, because the Kidney Foundation really does help people with transportation costs that, you know, if they have to go to dialysis and perhaps they can't take the TTC, so they need to take a cab because of, you know, health concerns, trying to buy, you know, good food that's actually kidney friendly, but also, you know, making sure that they have these great peer support programs and social programs to help people, because it's a very isolating disease. I mean, if you're on dialysis for 10 hours a night, you're not going out for dinner or even, you know, in non-COVID times, going out for dinner with your friends
and
being able to visit people.
Yeah.
So the Kidney Foundation does a lot of really good work in this space.
Christina, quickly, your cousin's name?
Her name is Christine.
Christine! Of course, Christine. You're literally bonded, even by name. Thank you so much. It's so good to see you. And if people are thinking I'm not on social media, don't worry. You could donate. Go to 6degreeschallenge.com. Love to you. It's so good to see you.
You too. Take good care.
You too, hon. Coming up next, Nicole. Okay, she's going to show you a dinosaur drive-thru. Oh, there it is, a T-Rex. I see a T-Rex. It's not Jurassic Park. It's much friendlier. It's coming up right after this. That T-Rex can run, boy.